Social Security Administration, how can I help you today?
Yeah, I just got home and there was a message to call this number about my Social Security.
All right. Well, sir, can you just let me know when did you receive a call? When did you get a call?
Oh, gee,
from our department?
It must have been a few minutes ago because I just got home.
All right. So, along with the call, sir, did you receive any kind of reference or any kind of case number with you?
No.
All right. Well, sister, the reason of this call is to inform you that there is fraudulent activities going on under your social security number in the state of Texas. So do you have any knowledge about this case?
Well, no, I don't know anything about this case. I don't know.
Yeah.
Well,
so here's some, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sir, I will let you know.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, I'm just nervous. Go ahead.
All right. So, sir, see, I will let you know each and every information against your social security number, okay?
Okay, yes.
So, all right.
All
so,
right.
May, sir, in order for me to go ahead and pull out a case file and provide you each and every information in the right manner, can you verify me a frozen last name along with your mailing address?
My first name is Peter, P-E-T-E-R, last name Zinya, Z-I-N-Y-A.
Z-I?
N-Y-A, Peter Zinya.
All right, Peter Zinya. All right, Sir Peter, can you confirm your mailing address?
100 Main Street, Moravia, New York, 13118.
Moravia, all right?
Yes, M-O-R-A-V-I-A.
All right. It's in New York, right?
New York.
And what's the zip code, sir?
The zip is 13118.
All right. All right. So, Sir Peter, see, as I told you, that there is fraudulent activities going on under your social, right? So, well, Sir Peter, we have got all this information, as well as we have got order from the law enforcement agency, as well as from the state court, okay? To go ahead and suspend your social security
suspend
number.
Suspend mine?
So here, yes, sir, I will
that's
let
what,
you know
that's
each
what
and
I
every
live
information.
On. That's what I live on. Well, how can you suspend mine? I don't understand
sir
this.
Peter,
yes.
Sir
oh.
Peter? Sir Peter, please calm down.
I can't,
I'll be
how
explaining
can I calm
you,
down? Oh, okay.
See, Sir Peter,
yeah.
We found your name and your social number in the state of Texas, okay?
Oh.
And it's been using in the fraudulent activities. Here, which we found under your name, that is money laundering
oh.
Act and drug trafficking Act. Under
drug
your name
trafficking.
And under your social name.
Huh?
Yes. And I believe you know very well about drug trafficking and money laundering, right?
Well, not very much. I'm 70 years old. I don't know anything about that stuff.
Yes, sir, Peter. Sir Peter, please calm down. I'm
no.
not directly saying or I'm not involving you, okay?
Okay.
We are not involving you. You are being in a primary suspected on this case, okay?
Okay.
So that's the reason we're trying to reach you.
Okay.
Is that you or someone else trying to misuse your information in the state of Texas? Okay?
Okay. Okay.
So that's the reason, sir.
All
yeah.
right.
We want
okay.
you to be cooperate with the Social Security Administration.
I will, I gotta
so
do.
Go ahead and get
oh,
the real culprit
okay.
as
get,
well as
yeah.
go ahead and safeguard the free information.
Okay.
Did you get my point, sir?
Yeah, I got the point. Let's
all
go.
Right.
What I gotta do.
All right. So, Sir Peter, it's a lesson. Before I go ahead and provide you more information regarding your crime case, I would like you to remind that this call has been on a recorded line with the federal government, U.S. Marshal, and the Treasury Department, okay?
Oh, okay.
And Sir Peter, we are taking this recorded line as your statement to prove inside the courthouse that you're innocent and you are not involved in any of these legal acts,
no,
like
not.
Money laundering
I'm
and
not.
Drug trafficking.
I'm telling
okay?
you, I'm not. Oh.
Yes. So, yes. So, Sir Peter, I want you to be honest.
I will.
Okay? And I
okay.
want you to be cooperative.
Okay.
And keep it confidential.
Okay.
So, at the moment, Sir Peter, can you just let me know where you are exactly? At this right moment, are you in a workplace or at your room?
Work. I'm 70.
Somewhere
no, I'm home.
All right. You're in your own home, right? So seriously, as I told you, this recording will be playing inside the courthouse.
Okay.
Instead of your favor or against you. Okay.
Okay.
So I want you to be honest and truthful, and we need to write it.
I am. All right.
So, Sir Peter.
All right.
All right. Go ahead. Do you have a piece of paper and pen handy around with you?
Let me find something here. I gotta find something.
All right.
Okay, go ahead. I got it.
All right. So, Sir Peter, first of all, you can note down my information.
Okay.
For your reference, okay?
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
My first name is Jeffrey. J-E-F-F-E-R-Y.
Okay.
Jeffrey.
Jeffrey. Okay.
And my last name is Morgan.
Morgan.
M-O-R-G-A-N.
Okay. Jeffrey Morgan.
All right. Yes, okay. Sir. And Sir Peter, even you can note down my beach ID number, which is FTC.
FTC. Go ahead.
54.
54.
54.
54.
12. 12. 00.
00.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. I repeat my beach ID number.
Oh, okay.
That is F as in Frank.
Yes.
C like in Tom.
Yes.
C like in Charlie.
Yeah.
Number 5.
Uh-huh.
Number 4.
Uh-huh.
Number 1.
Yes.
Number 2. And 00.
Okay.
All right. And Sir Peter, now you can note it down. Your case ID number, okay? Your case ID number. That is C as in Charlie.
C. Okay.
D as in David.
C, D.
Mm-hmm. 79.
79. Okay.
7112.
7112.
Yes, it's 797112. Did you get it, sir?
I got it, yes.
All right. And, sir, at this primary suspect case, you have been an arrest warrant, okay?
Arrest warrant?
You have been charged.
For me?
Yes. Sir, please note it down, okay? I'll be explaining you, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Go ahead.
70 40 10 10.
Okay.
Yes. So, sir, as I told you, this is your arrest warrant, right? Because
I don't want an arrest warrant.
Sir, listen to me first.
Okay.
There has been arrest warrant under your name, and you are being charged by money laundering and drug trafficking, okay?
I don't know anything about that type of thing.
Yes, so that is the purpose. I want you to be honest,
and
we need you truthful, okay? All right, thank you, sir. I really appreciate that.
Okay.
And see, sir, after our conversation, we will be fixing an appointment with you at your doorstep, and the officer will be coming down with you. They will be having a word with you, and they'll be providing you with every information, okay?
Okay.
All right. So, well, sir, here. See, now after our conversation, once I finish my report, I'll be forwarding this case to the DEA. That is Drug Enforcement Administration. You'll be having a word with them. I'll be connecting your call, but let me finish my part, okay? And that's it.
Uh-huh.
They'll be asking you the case number as well as the reference number with you. So make sure you have noted down, okay?
I got it. FTC 54541212 00.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Sir Peter,
yes.
Can you soon now?
Yeah.
In order for me to pull out this file and forward this information to the Treasury Department,
okay.
Can you confirm me the last 4 digit of your social number? The last 4?
Yes, 1463.
1463. All right. And Sir Peter, can you confirm your date of birth?
3/16/1950.
It's 1950, right?
Yes.
All right. So, Sir Peter, can you please hold the line for a moment? Let me forward all this information to the Treasury Department.
Okay.
And I'll be right back along with your case file, okay?
Okay.
All right. And make sure, do not disconnect the line. Do not put me on a mute. Do not put me on a hold. Because we are recording each and every conversation to proof, okay?
Okay.
This call will be the last call for you.
Okay.
All right. So please hold on for a while. I'll be right back. Thank you for your patience, sir.
Okay.
All right. Thank you for your patience, Sir Peter. Are you still connected with me?
Yes, I'm here.
All right. So, sir, I have a question. I have a couple of questions to you.
Okay.
So can you please let me know? Would you provide me the mailing address, 100 and Main Street? Is that your own home or you are been renting, sir?
No, it's my own home.
That's your own home, right? So seriously, have you ever entered your personal information in online in any cities while applying for loans or like a credit card?
No.
Or like a paid loan? Have you ever entered?
No. No, I would never do that.
All right.
That's
all right.
Stupid.
And apart from there, have you ever lost your personal identity, like your social card, like your state ID, your driver license, your cell phones, your wallet? Have
nope.
you ever lost in the past?
Nope, never lost any of them things. I lost
all
my
right.
license
and
once,
you...
but that was because of a
all
DWI,
right.
so that's not really not losing it. They took it. They took it.
All right. So, sir, can you let me know? Have you ever been to the state of Texas?
Yes.
All right. Can you please confirm me in which year did you remember?
I was in Texas 1999 with Willie Whalen and the boys. We went on a little vacation out there in Luckenbach.
All right. And at the moment, do you have any of your friends or your family members from the Texas?
No, we went there on vacation because we wanted to get out of Nashville. We were all living in Nashville, and we had to get out of there because it was making us crazy. We were feuding like the Hatfield and McCoys, so we went to Luckenbach, Texas.
All right. So, Sir Peter, have you
yes.
Ever been out of the cities or out of the countries like Mexico or in Colombia, Jamaican, Pakistan, Ireland? Have you ever visited,
Ireland?
Like your personal
no,
world
I've
or
never,
in your vacation?
I've never been to Ireland, no.
Oh, so have you ever visited Mexico or Colombia? No?
No, why would I go there? I don't even speak the language. I wouldn't know what to say.
All right.
Okay.
So, well, sister, there are three reasons of this case, okay? There
okay.
have been three reasons of this case.
Okay.
Firstly, there are multiple addresses listed under your name. And secondly, we have received a full course of drug possession under your personal social. And thirdly, we have received a complaint file under your name and your personal information, as well as trying to defer the government of the United States with cause of money laundering.
Defer the government? How do you,
prevency. Yeah.
How do you defer the government? I don't even know what that means.
Yes, they're trying to use your information, okay? And they're trying to convert you in a criminal, okay? So that's the reason.
They're trying to
I
convert
to be...
me into a criminal. You can't convert somebody into a criminal who doesn't want to be one.
Yes, they've been using your identity, okay?
Them bastards.
So let me finish my part,
I'm sorry for swearing. Oh.
Sir, please
okay.
calm down, okay?
I can't.
No need to be worried.
Oh,
okay?
Okay.
We are here. No need to be worried. We are not going to arrest you, or you're not going to be doing anything, okay?
Okay.
We just need your right information.
Okay.
All right. Well,
okay.
So, seriously, Sir Peter, our investigation been started when we found an abandoned car, okay, in the southern border of Texas, and that car was Toyota Corolla. So, well, this car was laying idle on the street, and then the local reported about the car to be suspicious, and which the local sheriff investigated that car. They found contained some blood as well as drug and 9 mm empty bullet inside that car. And hence, after investigation,
any guns? Did they find any guns in there?
Yes, empty bullet. It's empty shell bullet.
Empty
okay?
bullets.
We found.
I mean, right. somebody shot somebody.
And after investigation,
oh, boy. Okay.
Yes, sir. And after investigation, we found that car was being rented under your name and under your personal social number, and along with two address linked with the title of the vehicle. Okay.
Okay.
So, Will, is that your own car? Do you have your own Toyota Corolla under your name, sir?
I don't have a Toyota Corolla. I know. I got a Ford F-150. I got a Ford F-150. It's a good truck. I got a truck.
All right.
I don't even have a car. I got a truck.
You just got a truck.
It's a 4x4.
It's 4x4, right?
4x4 truck. Oh, it goes through anything.
It's a truck.
Yeah.
All right. All right, so let me finish my part, okay?
Okay.
Two sources are Peter.
Okay.
As I told you, there is two address listed with the title of the vehicle, okay? So here the first address, that's Houston, Texas, okay? And then the second address in the city of Rulid, which is raided by the U.S. Marshal, but unfortunately, there was no one inside the residence, but we have recovered 8 pounds of cocaine, which has been absolved. Drug, 8 pounds of cocaine, okay,
which
has been absolved. Drug
seems like a lot.
Listen to me first.
Okay, okay.
Yes, I don't want you to interrupt me. Okay.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm nervous.
All right, not a problem, sir. And also, we found some paper and documentation.
Okay.
Financial institutions like Bank of America, Wells Fargo, Chase Bank, Citibank, USA Bank, PNC Bank. And apart from that, we found 5 business accounts under your name and under your social number, okay? So here, the question been erased. When we were investigating all these accounts, locally and internationally, when we found more than millions of dollars of money
millions
has been wired.
I don't have millions of dollars.
Yes, listen to me first, sir. Money has been wired, transactions to the narco countries, and that is received from Mexico and Colombia, okay? And here is the person who received in Mexico was in the name of Julian Ramis. And then the second person from Colombia was in the name of John Rabillo Gonzalez. Have you ever heard this name before, sir?
I knew it. What was the first name?
It's a Julian Ramis.
Julian Ramis. I knew
a
dancer.
And then the second
A dancer once. Her name was Julia, but... it was a long time ago. She used to work at the Book and Noggins. It was a gentleman's club, and I used to go there, and I knew her, but I don't know her anymore. I haven't seen her in years. I'm sure she's old now, like me.
All right. All right. So, Sir Peter C., the person, there have been 6 persons suspected on this case. So it might be your friends or your family members or like your good neighbors. At the moment, we can't say that the right person has been using, okay? We are being in a suspected, so that's the reason we're trying to reach you, okay?
Okay.
And here, seriously, as I told you, 7 car has been rented, registered under your name, as well as 22 bank account has been operated under your name and been using in a fraudulent activities, okay? And there are still more than $200,000 has been on that account, which is on the 2 bank account, as well as 11 credit card. And here, see, the Treasury Department has decided to shut down all these 22 bank accounts, as well as 11 credit card, to keep your records clean, okay?
Okay, that's a good idea, yeah.
So, yeah. So, at the moment, sir, I need an assist verification. And at this SS verification, I'm not going to ask you like your bank account number or like your routing number or like your credit card number, okay?
Okay?
I just need the right information. Here we found 22 bank account under your name. So can you just let me know which bank you have been banking at the moment and how long you have been member with that bank? Can you please let me know?
My bank? Yes, TD Bank.
It's a TD Bank, right?
Yes.
And but, how long you have been?
Oh, years, member? years. I years. Right.
All right. So apart from there, do you have any another bank?
No, I only use one bank. I don't have that much money. I need more than one bank.
All right. There's that a TD Bank, right?
I believe
that's a debit card, right?
Yeah, I got a debit card with it. Yeah.
Yes. Any credit card under your TD Bank?
Yes, I got one Visa.
Can you just name out that Visa?
Visa. V-I-S-A.
Just a Visa. All right. All right. And sir, any plan, like a 401k IRA plan? Any plan? Any money investment?
No, I don't have none of that. I'm retired. worked on a fishing boat. I used to work on a fishing boat. It was the masturbator.
Please calm down, sir. Okay. Please calm down over this recorded line, okay?
Okay, I'm sorry.
And not a problem. And I believe you receive a disabled check?
No, it's regular, no? It's regular Social Security. I wasn't disabled being a masturbator. I mean, it was hard work, but I wasn't disabled. It was just a plain regular retirement. They told me it was time to leave. I was making a mess of the boat.
Well, Suhair, seriously, I'll be forwarding all this information to the Treasury Department, and they will be doing a cross-verification, okay?
Okay.
And your bank will not be shut down. So at the moment, can you just let me know at your Treasury Bank you're holding as a savings or a checking account?
I've got both. I've got a checking and a savings at the bank.
And is that your personal account or it's a joint account?
No, it's my own. I don't have nobody.
I ain't got nobody. All right. So, Sir Peter, can you let me know what will be the balance at your savings account, at your rough idea? Can you just let me know?
Roughly $800
at your savings, right?
Yes.
And what will be the funds on your checking, sir? At your rough idea?
Probably 500.
Probably 500, right?
So I got.
What is the limit, and what is the limit of your Visa, sir?
I think it's 6,000.
All right. So is there any available balance?
No.
Or it's a max out?
It's maxed out.
All right. You didn't have any funds in your Visa card, right?
No, I don't. It's maxed out. I have to use it for medication. And
Sir. All right. Not a problem, sir. Let me forward all this information to the Treasury Department, as well as I'll be connecting your call to the senior officer from the DEA Department, and they will be let you know each and every information what you have to do, okay?
Okay.
All right. Please hold on for a moment, okay?
I will.
All right. I really appreciate. May God bless you at this case.
Thank you.
Make sure do not disconnect, and I want you to be cooperate with the DEA, okay?
I will tell them everything.
All right.
Thank you for holding the line. Your line has been connected to me. My name is Eric Holder.
Eric Holder?
May I know whom am I speaking? Yeah, Eric Holder.
Okay. Okay, Peter.
Okay.
What?
I'm sorry, do you want me to repeat my name?
No, I got it. I wrote it down, sir.
Okay, right. So may I know whom am I speaking with at the moment?
Peter Zenya.
Oh, Peter Zenya. Okay, how are you doing today, Mr. Zenya?
Okay, until I got this call.
Right. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, please, Mr. Zenya.
Go ahead and what? I don't know. I got this call, that's all.
Okay. So, Mr. Zenya, I believe that you had a word with one of the officers.
Yeah,
the officer
Jeffrey
from
Morgan.
The Social Security.
Yes, Jeffrey.
Yes.
He told me everything, yes.
Right. Okay. So, right now, your line has been connected to me.
Okay.
In order... just because you have an intention to rectify your case, right?
Well, yeah, I don't want to get arrested. I'm 70 years old. I can't go to jail.
Right, sir. Okay. So, right now, I want you to write down my employee ID number.
Okay.
It's, if you're ready.
I'm ready. Go ahead. Let me know. Go ahead, Eric.
It's, okay. It's G as in...
Government. Okay.
D as in Delta.
Delta.
69941.
941. Okay.
Right. Did you got that?
GD69941.
Right. Okay. So, sir, I am just gonna read out the charges which I have right in front of my system, okay? The charges that has been pressed against you. And I want to make sure if I understood, okay?
Okay.
All right. Now, what I can see here right now is that there are an abandoned car which was found in the state of Texas.
Yeah, Jeffrey told me all this. This is a Toyota Corolla.
Okay, I just want to make sure.
I know all that. I know all that.
Okay. That's great. Wonderful that if you know this case. So I'm going to go ahead and explain to you how you're going to secure your accounts or you're going to secure your funds, okay? First of all, let me also explain to you in regards to your social security number. Your social security number has been found linked with the fraudulent activities in the state of Texas, right?
Right.
So basically, your name is linked, registered with your social security number, right? And we have found a multiple bank accounts that are found under your name, linked with your social security number. And there are 16 bank accounts and 11 credit cards. And from those accounts, $300,000 had been transacted to an fraudulent account for money laundering and drug trafficking. Right.
He told me all that, but it's not me. I told Jeffrey not me. I don't have that much money.
Right,
I'm retired.
True.
I used to work on a fishing boat. Oh, I was the masturbator there.
Okay. So, right, sir. So your social security number, all the accounts that are linked with your social security number are going to be suspended. It's going to be blocked for the next 45 minutes.
What?
So we are running short of time.
What about my Medicare and my social security? That's what I live at.
Right. You don't worry. I am going to explain to you how to secure your funds.
Okay.
Now, you have to secure that funds into a government safety locker. Okay? It is not a metal box, a government safety locker. It
is
a
metal?
Facility.
It is not. Okay.
It is a facility for 24 hours provided by the courthouse, the government, in order to secure the funds for a cases like an identity theft like yours. Okay.
Okay. Where is
so
it?
You have to listen to me.
Okay.
First, this safety locker, a government safety locker.
Government,
it's like a debit card, which can hold the funds for you.
Okay.
Which hold the funds for 24 hours, okay? Now, I believe that you have a TD Bank debit card.
TD Bank,
Can you tell me the valuation of your checking account at the moment right now?
Checking, I have 500. Savings, I have 800. That's all I got.
Okay. So what you have to do is that you have to go to first of all, in order to secure that funds into a government safety locker, you have to get the certified voucher. You have to get the government certified voucher.
Where do I get them?
And
I don't know.
You will get, don't worry, I will explain that. You have to get the government certified voucher, and you will get the government certified voucher in a government authorized certified store. Now, once you secure that funds into a government certified voucher, I'm going to register those under your name into a government certified bond. And right after that, I am going to fix an appointment for you with my assistant and two government officers at your residence tomorrow in the morning or late in the evening. Okay.
Why?
So that,
why would they come here?
So that,
are they going to arrest me?
So that they are going to come with some documentation and a paperwork. They are going to sit back with you and brief you about this whole criteria about this case. And then they are going to provide you the documentation.
Okay.
They are going to provide you the documents and some paperwork.
Okay.
And then they are going to allot you a new social security number, which will be in the envelope. Okay, now they're going to cross-verify the voucher, the certified voucher, which you are going to get today.
Okay.
And they're going to cross-verify and check with the accounts department and see where the funds is coming from and who have secured these funds and who under whose name these funds is secured.
Mine,
okay,
right?
And then they're going to, Right, because you have to go and secure that under your name. So they're gonna check that, and once they verify, they are gonna transact the amount back to your respective account. Okay, you're gonna able to access your account.
I'm gonna get a voucher and then put the money on a voucher, and then tomorrow I get my money back, right?
Right, tomorrow you get your money back.
Okay, as long as I get it back. Clear? I only got $1,300 to my name.
Say that again.
I only got $1,300 altogether.
Right, and it will be under your name. Tomorrow it will be transact the same amount to your account.
Okay. All right.
Hints? All right. First thing we have to understand that you are on a recorded line.
I know. Jeffrey told me that. Yeah.
Right?
Yes. They're going to use it for evidence.
That's correct. All right. So one thing I want you to understand is to cooperate with me, okay?
I'm gonna.
So you have to stay connected with me.
Okay.
Do not put on mute.
Okay.
Do not put on hold.
Okay.
Or make sure you stay connected with me. And the second thing is that all the information that are provided by the Jeffrey Morgan, the official Jeffrey Morgan,
yes,
and the information that I'm providing to you over this federally recorded line, those are sensitive information, and those sensitive informations needs to be kept confidential, because those are your private information, right?
My private information is right. I don't want nobody else
to
know.
Personal information.
I don't want nobody else to know.
Right.
I'm gonna get arrested. Oh boy.
Say that again.
Nobody to know I'm getting arrested. Jeffrey said they were going to come and arrest me.
No, they're not. I am going to cancel the warrant of your arrest.
Okay, thank you. Oh, yes.
My pleasure, sir.
Oh, don't take advantage
of me. Right. So you don't have to panic, or you don't have to worry. I'm here to guide you.
Okay.
Right. Now, so that is why you need to keep this this sensitive information. You need to keep this privacy confidential, which means that you don't have to disclose or discuss this matter to any third party, like your family, friends, or your neighbor, or your colleagues, until and unless you see the officer at your residence.
Okay.
Until unless you see the documentation.
Okay, I'll see it. Yes.
You're not gonna discuss this matter to any third party.
No.
All right.
I won't tell nobody.
Okay. Wonderful. Now.
Okay.
You have to go to to get the government certified voucher, right? And you will get the government certified voucher. It will be available in the government authorized certified store in an Target. Or in any government certified store in such as Target, or any certified store such as Best Buy, or an Apple.
Apple.
So, yes, an Apple store like
Apples?
An Apple store or in a Best Buy.
Store, or
a Target store.
How am I gonna get there? I don't know.
Which certified store is nearest to you?
There's a Target here in Moravia.
It's a Target?
Yeah.
That's one of the closest one from your location?
Yeah, but how am I going to get there?
Do you have to go there?
I don't know how I'm going to get there. I can't drive.
You can't drive?
I got a torn perineum. The doctor told me not to drive with my torn perineum.
When was the last time you drove?
2 weeks ago. Before I tore my perineum. Do you know what a perineum is? It's the part near your asshole, which is what you are, you scamming bastard.
Same to you. You
betrayed. You knew I was fooling. You fucker, you didn't know anything, you stupid fucker, to take my last $1,300 fucking dollars. You thieving bastard.
Black, motherfucking bastard.
Fuck you, you thief. Take my last $1,300 from some old man, you fuckstick. You still there, stupid? Nope, he's gone.